Hello everybody, I am Anjali and welcome again to my channel. Today in this video I'm going to show you how to make long sari blouse. So this is the sari blouse. So this is really easy to make, so let's get started. But before that, if you have not subscribed to my channel, then please go and hit the subscribe button and subscribe to my channel. So let's get started. So this is the fabric. With this I'm going to make my blouse and this will be for the lining. So first I'm going to give measurements on my lining part. So this is the lining part. So here I have got two equal pieces, one for the back side and one for the front side. So I'm going to cut both the sides together. So I have kept it like this. Now I have four layers of fabric. So the measurement will be like whatever length you want for your blouse, add 2 more inches to it for the adjustments. And width will be like whatever the measurement of your round hip area is where your blouse will be ending. Take that area measurement and then take half of it and add 5 more inches to it. So here I'm taking 25 inch long fabric because the length of my blouse will be 22 inches. From folded side I'm going to start the marking. So first of all I'm taking half of my shoulder measurement, that is 7. So I'm marking 7 inch of marking here. Now from this 7 inch I'll go down and then I'll mark my armhole measurement. So that is 8. So I'll mark a point there and then I'll make this straight line. Now here I'm going to measure the measurement of my round chest. So whatever the measurement of your chest is, divide it by 4 and then add 1 inch to it. And then mark a point here. Now here I'm marking 4 inch width for my boat neck and then half inch down I'll mark my shoulder measurement. Now from this shoulder point I'll mark my highest point of the bust, that is 11. Now here I'll be marking the measurement of my bust. So again, whatever the measurement of your round bust is, divided by 4 and then add 1 inch to it and then mark a point here. Now for the waist I'll come 15 inch down. And similarly, I'll mark my waist measurement here. I will divide my waist measurement by 4 and then add 1 inch to it. Now here at the bottom part, I'll take the measurement of my bottom part where my blouse will be ending. And then similarly, I'll mark the point here also. Now I'll join all these points like this. Give a little bit of curve here and then join these points. Like so. Now here I'm giving 2 inch marking for the cutting. Here I'm going to mark the measurement of my armhole. So make 1 inch of line from this corner. Now take half of this line and make 2 centimeter line like this. Now join all these points with a curve. And for the back armhole you have to give curve in this box only. Here I'm taking 2 inch of depth for my boat neck. This is your choice how much depth you want to give to your blouse. So here my marking is done. Now I will cut this out. Now remove the back part and cut the front armhole. And if you want to change the neckline, you can cut the neckline also separately. So here my front part is done and this is the back part. For the back part, I will increase the depth of the neckline. Now you have to place your all the lining part on the main fabric like this and then cut it out exactly the same. So here my both the pieces are ready with the lining. Here you can see it's looking like this. Now we are going to complete the neckline. So for that, facing both the right sides together, you have to give stitch on the neckline. And here are my two sleeves. So I have already done video for that. I will leave the link below in the description box. You can go and check it out. So cut your sleeves according to that video. So now here I'm going to give stitch to the neckline. So facing both the right sides together, you have to give stitch like this. Here my stitch is done. Now I'm going to give small notches here. Now just turn this. So this is the right part of our blouse. Give a nice iron here and then a top stitch. So here I'm giving the top stitch. So here the neckline of my both the pieces are ready. Now join both the pieces from the shoulders. Here I'm giving stitch to the shoulders. Now I am attaching my sleeves to the armhole part. So now I'm going to fold the bottom part of my sleeves. So I'm taking 1 inch and I'm giving the marking here. So here my sleeves are attached. Neckline is done and this is the bottom part of our sleeves. Here I have given double fold and I have completed it. Now we are going to make two strips. So this is 4 inch wide and 25 inch long stripes. So we are going to attach these stripes to the blouse. So what I'm going to do is I'll just fold it in half, taking right side in, and then I'll give the stitch to the sides of this strip. So here you can see. So first from the one side I will make this slight curve like this and then I'll give the stitch. So this is really easy. Here you can see, first I have made this curve from one side and then you have to give stitch till the another end. Here my stitch is done and it's looking like this. Now cut the extra fabric from the sides. Now with the help of safety pin, you can take out the right part out. You can see how I am doing this. So this is very easy to do. Now take out the safety pin from the another side. Take out the corners properly. Here my both the stripes are ready and you have to give iron also. Now we are going to give the fittings to the blouse. So first I will start from the sleeves measurement and then I'll go to the chest point and then from the chest point I'll go to the waist point. And here when we will reach to the waist point, we will place our strips like this. And then we will give this stitch till the bottom part. So here you can see I'm starting from the sleeves. Here is the chest point. Now from here I'm going to the waist point and here at the waist point I have attached my strips. Now I am completing my fittings till the bottom part. So here my fittings are done, and then I have given two little folds to the bottom part of the blouse like this, and like this my bottom part is also done. My strips are attached, and this is the overall look of my blouse, you can see. So you have to tie this beautiful little strips to the front part of your blouse, and you can make a beautiful bow there. So this will give really smart look to your regular sari. So I hope you liked this video and you will learn something new from this. And if you liked it, then please give this video a big thumbs up, share it with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And you can follow me on my Instagram handle also. All the links are below in the description box. I will see you in my next video. Till then, bye bye and take care.